on the 4th of July, I finally am gonna have something to eat. It's a bear claw and chocolate milk. Now, isn't that just the breakfast of champions? I'll reimburse him. He'll be just fine.
Okay. Regina, I feel like it's like game day or something.
Yeah.
Like it's very game-like.
Yeah.
My goal is just that everybody does what they're supposed to do, and it just runs as smooth as that water is out there on the lake.
My state of mind when the grills are both full, mine's full, whoever else is cooking, theirs is full, the phone is ringing, you've got walk-ups that are coming to the walk-up window. My concentration is on that order that's sitting first in line. Once it's taken care of, then we'll move to the next order or the next couple. I can cook two or three tickets at a time, and my focus has to be on timing. You have to time every item that goes down in those fryers, you have to time every item that goes on the grill itself, and you have to make sure that you've got everything in order so that when you put it down, it comes up in a certain order so that as you take it off, there's a certain sequence to everything that just makes it real smooth.
January 2nd every year. I meet with vendors, get pricing, start advertising for employees, and order all this bull meat so that we can start grinding the first week of February. It takes us approximately 6 weeks worth of grinding in order to have enough to get us through to the end of May.
Now, I can't wait till tomorrow because I get better looking every day.
There is always a little humor in here too. So this is a process that Dad actually started back in 72.
This white hat that's on my head, we're down to the last box of them. My dad wore them, and my brother wore them, and they don't make them anymore, so.
We're down to the last box, and Corey wears the last of them. So when you see that hat, of course, first person you think of is Dad.
Brings back.
I swear that was Shane that just walked out that back door, or Dad. This becomes a family affair. That's my daughter Cassidy. She was about what, eight when Cassidy started. That's when I took over the operation of the restaurant, and so Cassidy would come up and stay with me, and she'd put on her little blue Burgerville shirt. And
you probably sold lots of burgers.
No, I was never allowed up front.
When I took over the restaurant, Cassidy would come up and she would stay with Mom. But Mom would bring her out to Burgerville, and she would sit in Dad's chair.
And I sat there for hours and hours while my mom worked, and then we'd pack up and we'd go to Grandma's and we'd sleep there and we'd do it all over again the next day.
All day long, sit in Dad's chair, just to be there, just so that we were together.
I remember times when Cassidy would be in the back and we would need something done, and she was just a little tyke, and we would be like, Cassidy! And she would save our butts.
It wasn't really working. It was more of just kind of, I want to help out. I want to be with the girls, talking, stapling bags, kind of. I always looked up to them. They were the cool, you know, ones.
But she knows pretty much every part of the process, and she can do anything that she asks, so.
I like that I'm with my family. and that it has so much history behind it, that it's 60 years in the making and that it's who we are.
I didn't know I'd go from being a tax accountant and whatever to being a butcher, but life brings you what it brings you.
Each year when March rolls around, we gear up and start getting ready for the first day that Richwine's open, and we plan a family outing to go there and visit Marsha and eat their amazing food.
And you go through the paper and you keep waiting for that sign that says Richwine's opening.
When they finally move those blue barrels out from in front and plow it, you know it's almost time. Mm-hmm. I remember telling Mom when Dad passed away, Mom, don't you ever worry about Burgerville. I would have never dreamed that 3 years later we would be in a situation where Shane would be leaving us. And I felt it was very important that I continue operating Burgerville that year that, you know, Shane was sick.
By Easter, he got the family together and he said, I can't do this. He said, I'm gonna close it. And when everybody got together and they realized that was his livelihood, you know, and the family got together and they decided to keep it open that year. And so Lucy and I worked it during the week, and Marsha came up on weekends, and Corey came in when he could, and we just all kept it going that last year that he was alive.
And my mom came up and would balance the tills for him. She'd learn how to do payroll, and she'd come up here after her job at home, do it with him, and come right back home.
I'm feeling good. I'll be ready come Friday. I think probably the hardest part is knowing that tonight will be my last night at home.
Cameron's probably sacrificed the most out of all of this. He's been my support, and when I need him, like today, I needed some hot water in my camper and I needed my TV fixed, and he was out shoveling some snow and moving some gravel. When I need him, he's there. It's not his favorite place that he likes to be at, but he's always there to support me whenever he can.
It's been a long winter here in Polson, an awful long winter, and everybody's excitement about us opening and getting that first hamburger of the season, you know, that's what it's all about, because the reason we're here is because of our customers. And not only are they our customers, but they also become family. And so it's exciting to be able to even see some family come through.
Trudy, this is her third season with me. Just a super hard worker. This year she has just blossomed. Trudy just comes on over at 7, 8, 9 o'clock in the morning and away she goes, and she's just been fabulous at the grill. She's just a right hand. I'm just very blessed to have her.
I've had several jobs, but I haven't worked with a better manager than Marsha. She is very detail oriented and she'll help you. Marsha is right there, right alongside of you, and encourages you. And that's really a key thing for my boss. I think that if they're there for you and encouraging you to do better, then you're going to want to work for them and you're going to want to work right alongside with them.
My husband and I went to Richwine's Burgerville, which was a real treat because I remember Richwine's, everybody talking about Richwine's, and you got to go there. They're burgers and fries. So we went there, and on the window was waitress wanted. And my husband said, well, my wife needs a job. And I go, what? I didn't know he was leaving. So that set me up.
the best thing about the job is that when Grandma and Grandpa started this back in 1962, we're keeping that legacy going. They would be thrilled on how successful it's been.
Tomorrow's another day too.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so I'll see you tomorrow at 10 along with Elizabeth, and we'll continue forth.
When it comes to training, I actually try to start that about 10 to 14 days before I ever open the doors to the public.
Go ahead and put your phones. All phones have to go in the bucket.
I bring the associates in for about 3 hours at a time. I found that if you try to do any training for longer than a 3 hour period, you'll lose their concentration. So I'll bring them in some evenings from roughly 4 to 7, and we take a lot of time training on every aspect of what goes on in the restaurant.
What we're talking about tonight is the menu. And if you look at that, you'll notice that the menu is broken down into categories. There's burgers, there's specialties, sides, sandwiches, drinks, desserts, and extras.
It was very overwhelming. I was very nervous, and I kept wondering like if this was actually something I could do.
From taking an order on a guest check, to making an ice cream cone, to milkshakes, to actually going to the freezer and pulling out the item that is needed, that needs to go in down into the fryer that the customer has ordered. So it's very detailed.
So what we'll do is spend a couple nights where Marshall will just cook and you guys will just eat. So here's your fish and chips, your fries, your fish. There's the fish doohinky. So you'll go, oh, this is what a shrimp witch looks like, tastes like, feels like. Now I've got two more chicken burgers here. Okay, somebody else want the rest of that ice cream? Oh, you're still working on it, Will? There you go. Okay, so let's talk about burgers. The first burger that is listed on that menu is the Royal Burger. That Royal Burger has been on the menu since day one. There was a gentleman that actually owned Burgerville at one time by the name of Royal Morrison.
I remember when I moved here and became athletic director, I started hearing quite a bit about Royal Morrison, who had been a coach years before, and then found out that that's where the name for the Royal Burger came from.
Now, please watch. Ketchup. Mustard. Relish. And then he gets, because it's a deluxe, he gets a doohinky. So will you please watch? Yes. The doohinky goes in the top of the bun. And it just sits in there like that. When you get the blessings of making a doohinky, we will show you exactly how that's done. Because I've got my tricks as to how to cut the carrots and the celery and the radishes. No bigger than a nickel. No smaller than a dime. And if Grandma was standing here, she would bump in and she would say, this is a garnish, it is not a meal. So here's my celery. Where did I put my finger on this toothpick?
Right in the middle.
Halfway on that toothpick. Here's my radish, and here is my
If there is a job that the employees do not enjoy doing,
that's
believe me, that's the one. Me, it doesn't bother me. You just do it and get the job done. But that's one where they just kind of roll their eyes like, oh my Lord. But I'll tell you what, if a customer does not get that doohinky in their burger, boy, do I ever hear about it the next time they come through.
That's how the customer gets their vegetables. But then, sorry, my mouth is full. But then when they're done eating, they have a toothpick. If you put too much ice cream in that cone, it's gonna fall into the dip. Do you see? I'm not excited. It's not going anywhere. Okay?
Lovely.
All of our orders, we write on a guest check. Marcia doesn't have a point of sale system.
Oh,
Like that?
Yep, just like that. When it's collected, that is correct. Yep, exactly. But you don't circle it until it's been collected. And I try to do just a little bit at a time each night so that by the time I'm done at the end of the 10 days, then they're saying to me, okay, now I fully understand what you were trying to do and what this looks like. So I try to build on it over a period of time. The last thing that I want to do is to put them at a window on the day that we open, and they have not had practice working on a speaker.
She kind of covered everything that we were ever going to do so that on opening day we'd feel okay. And I thought that was really reassuring.
We're training, and I'm ordering the orders so they can do some practice and see if they can get it right and see if they can better help our customers.
Thank you for choosing Richwine's Burgerville. This is Will. How may I help you?
Hi, Will. I would like a chicken burger, please. I would also like 3 royal burgers, please.
Okay, barbecue sauce and onion. We also have 3 royal burgers. They come with ketchup, mustard, relish, lettuce, onion, pickle as well.
So it takes time. It's something that you don't want to rush because you want to make sure that they feel comfortable with what they're doing. Because if they're not, the customer's going to feel that.
Going into my first interview with Marcia, I was totally nervous because I had never had a professional interview before, and I was unaware as to what kind of questions she would ask and what she would expect of me. And her first question was, tell me about yourself. I, of course, said, what do you want to know? She stopped me in my tracks right away and said, never ask a person interviewing you what they want to know about you. Instead, she walked me through what I should answer. And from there on, I've had a little bit of an edge now where when I go into an interview, I know how to approach different questions and how to present myself in a proper way. So as soon as I met her, she acted as a teacher for me.
We hope you're enjoying this special presentation of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties. It's hard to watch this without getting a little bit hungry with delicious burgers. I'm John Twiggs, one of the program producers here at Montana PBS.
And I'm Anna Rao. I'm also one of the program producers here at Montana PBS. Thanks for joining us tonight.
It's all about supporting local programs, Montana programs on Montana PBS. If you support that, please become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. And when you do, we've got some great thank you gifts to pass along.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between 2 combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month, or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
We want you to take advantage of one of those thank you gifts. You know, Burgerville is a community gathering place, a place where you can grab a bite to eat or maybe visit with friends and get caught up on the local news. And in a sense, Montana PBS is also a community gathering place where we can all come together and share stories and tell stories. It might be about a small local business or music or art or Montana history, but that doesn't happen without your financial support. We want you to become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. You can do it right now. It's quick, it's easy. You can get on the phone and dial the number at the bottom of your screen or go online. Help keep our community connected. Become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. And thank you.
And now we are very lucky to have the producer and director of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties in our studio to talk to us a little bit about the program. David King, thank you so much for joining us tonight. I appreciate
it. Thanks for having me.
The first question has always got to be, why did you decide to do this program?
I was a customer at Burgerville for several years. My wife and I loved it, our kids love it. And the more I got to know the place and got to know Marcia and the people behind it, the more interested I became, and I thought, well, we should make a documentary about it.
So as another producer, I know sometimes those quarters can be very tight, camera gear, getting everything in there, and you were working in tight quarters in a kitchen. How did that go? What was the shoot like? Were there any challenges at all with a bustling kitchen like that?
I was like a big rock in a stream. I was just sort of, you know, trying to stay out of people's way, try to float around. It's almost like being a secret agent, you know? You just don't want to be in someone's way. But you get, it's like a finely oiled machine in there, and you start to understand the flows of traffic, where people will be, and you just do your best to fit in.
And you felt like you weren't in the way, you got used to the flow of everything.
You would probably have to ask Marcia and the employees about that, because I have a feeling that I was bothering them. But after a while, I think it was more like a fly on a wall. One day we had 7 cameras set up around that place running all day long, most of them in time lapse. And those were hanging from the ceiling and in the air, and it was just quite a process.
So one of the other questions I had is, I don't think a lot of people understand how much hard work goes into running this business. Were you surprised by some of that, even though you maybe knew Marcia and would go visit?
I knew her, but I didn't understand until I got involved in the film how all-encompassing it is. You know, Richwine's opens in mid-March typically, but Marcia starts on January 2nd, getting ready for that. And she is just going pedal to the metal throughout the whole season from then on. So, you know, in about a month they'll be opening, and Marcia's busy now, and you'll probably hear that from her. Unbelievable number of hours. She's at it at 8 in the morning and sometimes doesn't get out there till 11 at night. It just depends on what happens during that day.
All right, sounds good. Well, we'll talk to you a little bit more in a later break. Thank you so much. We'll talk to you a little bit more about the program. In the meantime, please give us a call. Let us know you'd like to become a sustaining member of Montana PBS.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
We're appreciating the phone calls we're getting this evening, all the support being shown for Montana programming on Montana PBS. Anna, we're partway into it so far. What's one part that's really jumped out at you?
Well, in this first segment we just watched, that whole discussion about how much training goes into each of those employees and how long the training goes on for. And also, I really love the line that Marcia had about, my job is to cook, your job is to eat. What a privilege for those employees to get to taste everything on the menu and really get to know every little detail. I don't think I've ever worked in a place where there was so much training and so much attention to detail and so much support for the employees. It was very, very impressive for me, and I think a lot of that's coming forward in the next couple segments you'll see as well.
Yes, it doesn't just magically happen.
No.
Yes, it's a lot of work that goes into that.
Yeah.
Well, we want to hear from you tonight. We'd like to hear from you to become a sustaining member for Montana PBS, and when you do, we've got some thank you gifts to pass along.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
We appreciate hearing from everybody tonight. We'd like to hear from all 56 counties. That would be a good goal for us tonight. So we're just about ready to head back to the show.
Yeah. And we're going to start to see the thing that we've been building up to, the hustle and bustle of opening day. I can't wait to see what happens. Let's watch.
I was 9 years old when she decided to take over the business. I don't remember her telling me she was quitting her previous job, but I do remember her saying, you know, I'm going to go work at Burgerville until grandma passes away.
So as I thought about it, I said, you know, this is something I need to do. I need to continue this on so that as long as mom was alive, that she could see that Burgerville was up and running and thriving. Burgerville was mom's baby. You know, it was another child to her. And then I cherished that restaurant probably more than all of us kids, just because I guess I know that it was started because mom needed to get a job so that they could, you know, help pay in some medical expenses that they had because of my early birth.
Suddenly she was gone a lot. That was hard. I was 9 years old. So for her to move an hour away was crazy. I never thought that that's what she would do, but it happened. Me and my dad have become really close over it, but yeah, it's hard. That mom, you know, teenage girl growing up needs her mom. And so for a dad to try to be there is kind of funky, but we made it.
Basically, he's my daughter's best friend because he's been there for her. He's raised her.
And my grandma passed away and we're still cooking, so.
When she passed away that November, you know, it was when I probably started thinking, I don't know how much longer I can do this because I don't have the support. And the following season was when Jeremy showed up.
This decision to come back was I just moved back to my hometown and I just stopped in to see Aunt Marcia and let her know I was back in the town. And it was like a day and a half later, she called me up and asked if I was looking for any more work.
That was a year after my mom had passed away, and I was short-staffed, and I was working until midnight 1 a.m, making hamburger patties myself for the next day, and I was worn out. I told Jeremy, I said, I need help. You need a job, and I need help. And he showed up the next day, and now it's, 3 years later? And he's still with me. And I'd be lost without him. He has taken probably 20, 30 hours a week off of my plate that I would normally put in.
My duties at Burgerville when I go in is I take care of all the hamburger patties, make the hamburger patties every morning or every night as of needed.
First patty of the season, I kind of over-squished it there.
Jeremy pitched in and was a godsend for Marcia because he does all of the patties of the hamburger. And that was something that Marcia was having to either do early in the mornings or when Lucille was still alive, the two of us would go in and we would make patties.
I mopped the floor, strained the grease, kind of Marcia's right-hand man.
Are you going to keep cooking me some?
No.
No.
We've become really close, too. We laugh a lot on the job, talk a lot about miscellaneous things, and he's very, very hardworking.
Working with Cassidy is, that's really neat because I'm the oldest grandchild, and she's the youngest grandchild. So, I mean, there's like 19 years difference there almost.
Jeremy is definitely the light and the humor of Burgerville, where he keeps us going. He keeps the environment friendly. He goes out to the customers and ensures that everything's okay.
Sometimes we all look at him and shake our heads just because he's Jeremy, but we all love him.
Grandpa Enoch would be there making hamburger patties, so then Dad would leave and go to the bank and get lettuce and stuff like that. So then Grandpa Enoch would always ask, you know, you want some breakfast? So it was a double cheeseburger for breakfast, and Grandpa Enoch would have a double cheeseburger for breakfast too, and he'd be like, hurry up and eat that so your dad don't see it.
He's my nephew, and I'm proud of him, and he works very, very hard to be able to support his family. And I'm glad to be able to offer that employment to him, but he's more back to me than whatever I'm giving to him. And so that really helped. But with a hip going bad, and with the stresses of the business and the employees, and mostly just not being with my family, was when I made the decision that, you know, maybe it was time for me to think about going back home and possibly looking, you know, for somebody to take over the operations of the restaurant.
I've been in there a couple times, and you could eat off the floor, and it's extremely clean and well run. So I don't know if anybody can step up to the plate and do what Marcia does.
Lucy was very meticulous about cleaning things. Monday was maybe the windows. Tuesday were the shelves. Wednesday were refrigerators. And to this day, Marcia still does that.
Okay, I'll let the kids do the rest.
Working for Marcia has made me a better person, 100%. She really set me up for success as a worker, as an employee, and developing the skills needed to work in any type of environment, as well as a person, because Marcia's almost like a mom too, where she'll provide those little life lessons and skills throughout the season. She just has a lot of amazing qualities that I really look up to, and I see her as a high figure in my life.
This is Jacob's, I think, fifth season with me. Jacob started as a freshman in high school, and he was 15 when he started, and so he had a limited number of hours that he could actually work due to wage and hour laws. But over the years, Jacob's really stepped up, and he's actually been cooking for me now for the last three seasons. Just a phenomenal kid. He's now a sophomore at SKC, going to college. And so I really work with him, being able to give him the time that he needs in school, but then he will then give me the time that he knows that he can give me at Burgerville. So we work together to make it happen for both of us.
I like them away from work, and I like them at work. More than anything else, I like that I could depend on them. I liked how they ran a business. I liked how they treated their people. I liked knowing what they expected. And I liked that they always stood behind me, and they took me under their wings, and they helped me through a very devastating time of my life. The ones you look back on and say, who did you learn the most from that was able to help you with everything else? And I think that's the biggest point with the Richwines. And for that, Marcia's got the same. She's got a little bit of her dad, and she's got a little bit of her mother. And she can put them together just beautifully and go, 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 go.
So when I walked through the door on the first day, and I turned the key, I tell Shane I wish he was the one that was here, and I promise him I'll do it right. And then I tell Dad I love him. And then I chew him out that he didn't make this place big enough. And some days there's just not enough space in there for all the food that we need, for all the employees that we need. We start running into each other to be able to take care of our customers. I need another grill and I need another ice cream machine and such, but it's what it is. So we deal with it and we get through. Tell him I love him and then I start chewing him out, and I do that all throughout the season whenever I don't have enough space. Dad, you did not make this place big enough. And then is when I think of Mom, and I know that she won't walk through the door today and make sure that I have everything the way it's supposed to be. She won't walk in and check all my refrigerators and tell me I need more doohickeys, or I'll clean your lettuce, or she's not standing there washing dishes. And that's probably a real hard one because I've had her for the last, you know, for my first six seasons. So I talk to them all every day.
You know they'd be proud.
I know that. I know that.
Okay, well, give me a shout when you're all done today.
I'll call you tonight when I'm done.
Have a good day.
You too. Thank you. Love you.
Love you.
Bye. That's the calls that get me through the day.
When Burgerville opens, it is pure happiness. I count down the days, and on the grand opening, I say to everybody at work, Happy Burgerville Day!
I'm Tasha Avison.
I'm Caitlin Burrows.
And we plan to be at Richwine's at 10 a.m. this morning.
Whose idea was it?
Tasha's. I think it was a joint discussion.
She talked about how she wanted a burger really bad, so that's how it all started.
Yep.
So what was the whole order?
A burrito, two corn dogs, a royal burger, a banana milkshake, a chocolate milkshake, a Diet Vanilla Coke.
French fries.
And French fries.
For the two of you?
Yep. And we ate it all.
The neat thing about going there now for us is that if she's at the grill or the window, she'll even come over and pull the window open and visit. And I'm sure she does that with everybody. We're not special. We're just some of the hundreds of locals that love going to Richwine's.
So you know she's going to come over and say hi and see how you are and what's going on in your life right now. And so that's always great.
Yep. She genuinely cares about your, just how you're doing overall. And while she's just working away over the flat top.
If you can go to Burgerville and say hi to Marcia and she makes your favorite meal for you and a milkshake, and you sit back and you know, it's a feel-good place, and it'll boost your morale.
God decided that he needed Shane more than we did. And Marcia needed a bigger kitchen. So he took Shane and he gave Marcia a bigger kitchen. What portion of your home is where you spend the most of your time and where you visit, and our kitchen is where we talk about the day? And well, that's what Burgerville is like. It's a huge kitchen, and that's where the good Lord has given me the opportunity to be able to cook for thousands and thousands of people every year. And I get to open that window while I'm cooking, and I get to talk to family and to friends. Hi, how's your day? How have you been? What are you doing today? Thank you for allowing me to cook your dinner today.
You betcha, have a good day.
Bye. I've shared memories with the community over that grill. I've shared opportunities with the community over that grill. It's just huge. It's where I've been able to build a relationship with my employees, with my customers, all over this big, huge kitchen.
Okay, this one's coming off. It's starting to come off. I have to cook it in two shifts, you guys, because I can't do it all in one. So get the fries in one bag. We're gonna have the burgers in another, please. There's four royals.
Teamwork is a really big thing. because it might be a really decent size order, 12, 15, 16 burgers, 16 milkshakes, and you just can't knock it out in 30 seconds. It's going to take a little bit to cook all that and make sure you got everything correct for the customer.
Phenomenal Bernie Burger today, and of course we're down here doing a live broadcast, and I will say this is probably the coldest live broadcast we've done. However, the line speaks for itself. People will come at any temperature for their rich wines. It's a Polson tradition.
But as you go by and you see all the people and the cars are lined up and you go, I remember those days, I remember those days.
I will give it a try. There you go.
Minnesota. I'm asked many times a week if I'm from Minnesota. I said no, I was born and raised here. I'm just married to a Norwegian from North Dakota. So it rubs off.
One, two. One has a fry sauce, one has a ketchup.
With mayo, barbecue sauce, and bacon, a double cheeseburger with bacon and fry sauce, and a family fries with four fry sauce. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I need you to make sure that everybody knows how to do the setups, that there's a plate, spoon, knife. We'll take care of them.
She never turns away a customer. 9 o'clock, there's still three people in line. Don't you dare shut the close sign off. Those people will be taken care of, and if there's other people in line that show up, then so will they.
You go, happy first day back.
Oh, well, honey, thanks, Dad.
I've got bags for you, so don't go anywhere.
Okay.
Oh, you're so awesome, honey.
My grandmother, look at, she's got goodies.
Hi, so this sweetheart. Is
our puppy, Dago Red. My grandma, Lovey, yeah, worked here back when Enoch and Lucy had it. My mother worked here.
The only thing that I have not done at Burgerville is grind in the meat house.
My daughter worked here, my sister worked here, my son worked here.
The magic question is how many Baileys worked at Richwine's Burgerville?
I can't even imagine.
Thank you, hon.
You betcha.
Bye.
And my pork chop sandwich is delicious.
Good, good.
I love their pork chop sandwiches.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, God bless her, right? There's only one Stephanie. No, that goes in there. All the straws have to go in the refrigerator, remember? And this is only the first day. Busy. I was blessed to see a lot of people I haven't seen for a while, and to be able to visit and catch up and find out how their winter was. And I still have a couple hours of work to do before I can ever walk out the door, so. Book work, you know, that has to be done, and I do all of that myself. And does anybody know where the lid to the short quick is, or sort quick, or whatever that's called? Oh my Lord, though, I'm gonna have a donut.
She does everything for everybody else and not enough for her, you know, like the whole not eating thing. She'll eat at 8 a.m. and then she'll eat at 11 p.m. at night because there's no time for that. I do talk to her about taking better care of herself, but I don't think she hears me. I think that's very selective hearing.
Marsha runs a madhouse. And I told her it's not even the 4th of July yet. She hasn't seen anything yet till the month of July.
These young people that are new there this year and just learning, and they just can't imagine why it's so busy.
It's been really great, but yeah, everyone says it gets even crazier.
Opening day was insane. Like, I don't think anything could have prepared me for that.
It's funny to watch them. You know, their eyes are big and they're just amazed at everything that's happening.
We were moving, and when we got done that night, it was really cool because everybody was really still very upbeat, even though we had been going 100 miles an hour.
Hey, Daniel, would you leave your apron with me?
Yes, I'm not.
I let her know when she was walking down the stairs, and I don't take it home.
Bye, night, Marsha.
See you later.
Bye.
By the end of the day, I was very tired, but I also felt really accomplished and, like, good because, you know, like, we made it through the day, and with, as far as I can remember, we didn't make many mistakes.
We are enjoying this special presentation of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties. I'm John Twiggs, one of the program producers here at Montana PBS.
And I'm Anna Rao. I'm also one of the program producers here at Montana PBS. Thanks for joining us for this program tonight.
We're taking a break in all the action for a chance for you to become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. And when you do, we've got a variety of thank you gifts to choose from.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month, or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
This program is all about the ties that bind us together. Our shared stories, our shared nostalgia, our shared history. Now, more than ever, we need to recognize and celebrate the bonds that make us Montanans. What better way to do that than to support this service? Montana PBS is here to tell stories that you might see someone you know in, stories that give us a sense of community. Why don't you join this community? Give us a call and let us know you want to become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. Thank you.
Well, look who's here. We have the star of the show. We're so excited. The matriarch of Burgerville. Marsha, welcome.
Thank you.
It's great to see you. And I'll start right away with what was it like having a camera follow you around that much for that long?
Well, I don't think that it really bothered us too much. We're too busy doing what we're supposed to do, taking care of our customers and such. So I don't think it really bothered us too much at all.
Yeah, we're adjusting right now, just getting used to seeing you in one place and not moving around a lot, because that's what we saw. You were constantly on the go. So as we sit here, we're enjoying the show tonight, and it's been on a couple of times prior to this. You've gotten a chance to see it. What was it like just to see yourself in the show?
It's a little nerve-wracking. I suppose the thing that really hits me home is when I see the pictures of my parents. That's when the emotions come out.
Yeah, it's true for the rest of us. Yeah. When we're watching it, you can feel that come out, just the family history of it. We see you busy, and of course the focus of it is during the season, but there is an off season. Mm-hmm. What do you get to do in the off season?
Well, in the off season, I spend time with my family. I have a couple sewing machines that I keep very busy. I like to travel. Obviously, this year's been a little different with that, but just to be able to be at home and to be able to be with my family and support them, that's what's most important.
Well, it's good to know you get some time to unwind.
Yes, I do.
And of course, one other question that I have to ask is, do you actually know every single person in Polson?
Not anymore. Probably 30, 40 years ago, yes, but there's been so many people coming in since then that I do not. I know a lot of faces, and not necessarily the names, but when they come through, I definitely recognize the faces.
Oh, well, I'm dying to ask you a couple more questions about the future, but we don't want to give anything away since we still have more of the show ahead, so we'll hold off on that. But we want you to support Montana programming on Montana PBS. Become a sustaining member and call now.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
I think one of the reasons that the program resonates with everybody all around the state is everybody has a favorite local place that they can think of. Now, you're a big city girl growing up in Helena. So did you have one growing up?
Oh, it's a metropolis, all right. yes, I did, actually. And just watching this brought back memories of eating at that place. It was called Gertie's, and it was open when I was a child, pretty young. I'm actually not sure when it closed, but I mourn that it is closed, because if they still had it, I'd still eat there. And I just remember the buns and how they fried the buns in butter and put them on the grill. It was just like nothing I had ever tasted, and I will never forget that from my youth. And I think a lot of people feel that way about Burgerville. You know, it's something from their youth and from their life.
Yeah, it does bring back a lot of great memories all around the state of Montana, and we want to hear from you from all around the state of Montana. To pledge your support to Montana PBS, become a sustaining member and take advantage of one of these thank you gifts.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
And we were just talking about, kind of from my youth, a burger place that we like, but Turnabout's Fair Play, you travel all over the state through back roads, and you probably ran into some really cool places. Can you tell us about those?
Well, the illusion is we go around the state for stories and to tell stories. Really, we go around the state to eat. Let's be honest.
So, they know yes. The best places.
Yes. So, yes, if you want some breakfast, 600 Cafe over in Miles City.
There you go.
Slice of pizza for lunch, Eugene's Pizza up in Glasgow. If you want a big hunk of prime rib, you can go down to Dillon and the Den. If you want some pie, Iron Horse Cafe over in Three Forks. I can keep going, but I'll just leave it there. But it's back to that point of, I think, when you watch the story about Burgerville, that it brings that back. And I think even when people maybe take that summer vacation, go to Flathead Lake, and they go by Burgerville, they're like, oh my gosh, I got to stop in there, because it reminds them of some of those fun local places.
Yeah, and I know it's going to be a place I will visit next time I'm in Polson. Won't you give us a call if you're enjoying this program? Let us know you support these types of programs at Montana PBS. Thank you.
At the beginning of the season, they would have a party where they would invite a couple of couples, and they would fry steaks and have a drink or two and celebrate the opening of Burgerville. And then at the end of the season, it was the same thing. They would have a party. It's closing up time, and it was vacation time, and they got to relax after working 7 days a week for the whole 6-8 months that they were open.
If I did get in trouble, I'd be in the back pouting or whatever, and if Dad wasn't in there, Grandpa would come back there, and he said, don't worry, your dad did the same thing.
And I can remember one time I walked into Burgerville. I was doing something in town, and I walked into Burgerville, and my dad says, hey, Mason, your mom and I want to kind of retire. Would you be interested in taking Burgerville over? And I said, no, Dad, I don't want to take Burgerville over, because I didn't want to say what I thought, but I said, I ended up just like you, just working 12, 14 hours a day, every day, all summer long. And I said, that's not, I can't do that. I can't do that, so.
Gosh, if someone else buys Burgerville, it's gonna be sad, really, really sad. But whoever that someone is, I hope you take care of it. And I hope you treat it like a baby. Sorry. Because it's a big deal to us. And it's supported us for a lot of stuff. The lot of things that we get to do is because of Burgerville. And so I hope you take care of it, and I hope that you want to be there, and I hope it's not just some job that you think you can start and let people run it for you and check up on it every once in a while, because it's not like that. It takes being there for whatever my mom does, 11 hours a day. It's not a franchise. It's deep roots to something special. And so that person is gonna need to want to love it as much as we do.
If Marcia leaves, whoever steps into that's got big shoes to fill. This is as well as it's ever been run, and I don't know how you could replace her.
I do not think Burgerville would succeed without my mom. My mom is the last kid under her parents. And I don't think any of us or any cousin could do what she does or do it better. And I don't think any of us know the people that she does or the ropes. And I don't think it means as much to us as it does to those three kids.
It's very hard to walk out that door and to leave that business, even right now, with others. Because that's our name on that building. And everything that goes on is a reflection of our family.
You definitely put your hours and your time in. There is no set time of when you need to be to work or when you'll get off work. You don't get off until the job is done.
Banner for Cassidy for graduation at the house. So here's the C. Now I'm going to make the A. So I'm making her name and a banner that's we're going to put on some pallets with her pictures and such on as a decoration for a background for graduation. These are the ones that I started for Burgerville to make for little banners to hang out on some poles. So I'll spend about an hour at night just playing around.
Back in 1989, I think it was my 7th and 8th grade year, in home ec class, for you to pass the 7th to go to 8th grade, what I did is I made a hamburger and I made a hot dog. And Grandma Lucy was really happy.
I do like working for my mom. She gives me anxiety, and I shouldn't say that, but She gives me anxiety when she's on my heels. I thought she would yell at me more than other people, but it's never been like that. When I'm trying to do things and she sees me do those things and she has to say something about it, or maybe I'm not doing it correctly, I hate that. I just want to be like, I know, I'm, let me do it on my own. I think everything has to be her way, and I know her way, I'm getting there by doing it my own way. And so when she does that, that frustrates me. But yeah, I do like working for my mom. I'd rather work for my mom than anybody else. And I get to be with her every day, so that's a bonus.
This Thursday, my daughter will be playing softball. She's a senior in high school at Frenchtown High School, and she plays for the Frenchtown Bronx. I didn't want to miss anymore. I've missed an awful lot over the last 9 years.
And I think once we realized that I only have 1 year left, then that was kind of a big deal. But I always told her that, you know, she didn't have to be there if she couldn't be there. It never really hurt my feelings at all, because I know she wanted to be there. I think it'd be different if she just flat out wasn't, you know, didn't care.
And I decided that since this was her senior year, that I was going to make sure that I attended every activity that she was involved in.
She never missed a game, no matter how far away it was, or, you know, if the weather was bad. She never missed anything. She never missed a senior awards event or a banquet for a sport. So she was present for a lot of it, and for a lot of it she said, hey, you know, we're gonna close Burgerville for the day, or we're gonna be open till 3 o'clock for a family first event.
I felt it was important for me to make the decision that if I didn't have the proper staff to be able to keep the doors open on a day that she had an activity, that I was then going to declare what I call a family first day. And it's a day where I feel it's important that my family comes first over the business. So everybody that works is gonna have a family first day. They can take that day and use it as they like, and I'm gonna take the day and go watch my daughter play softball.
And so that was huge to me, that she wanted to stop her life for a moment of mine.
Many times I've been driving by and feel like my car just involuntarily swerves in there, so it becomes addictive.
You know your customers, those that come in every single day. I can hear a voice on the speaker, and I know exactly who that customer is.
She knows what we order. We don't even have to tell her. She knows from no relish to that tomato on that cheeseburger down to the fry sauce with the onion rings.
They've been coming in for years. You just know what they want. Kay Stam and her large chocolate Coca-Cola. She just walks up to the window. You know what she wants. And those are what makes it so special. That's why we're there. It's our customers. Without our customers, we wouldn't be here for, starting our 58th season. That's what it's all about.
Marcus, we're gonna go to Richwine's and have French fries.
In the course of the season, we go there probably 50 or more, yeah?
Yeah.
When I'm feeling hungry, I get a double cheeseburger, plain ketchup mustard.
Double royal with cheese, no onion, and I usually have a large Dr. Pepper, but if Jeremy Richwine is there working, he knows to make me a vanilla shake.
Well, Richwine's Burgerville is the best last place in Polson, Montana to get good service, good food, a good time, and you get a doohinky with it. If you ordered the cheese deluxes, you get the doohinky with it. I've made many doohinkies.
I couldn't miss this place. I mean, the drive down Highway 35 from Kalispell to Polson
And at the end of it, it's just the icing on the cake with coming to Richwine's here and having that burger and fries. The fries are spectacular here too. I don't eat a lot of burger and fries, but boy, I had to come back here and get another heap and helping of that food.
On August 20th is the magical day when all of a sudden the numbers just drop and the flow into Burgerville, it's like somebody shut the water faucet off. On that day, I don't know why, but I've got history over the last 10 years that on August 20th, all of a sudden you see all the boats heading south and all the campers heading south, and people are coming up and telling you that they're closing up their cabins. The kids are starting back to high school. College kids are going back to school. So it just takes a big drop at that point in time. I've learned, don't make hasty decisions when you hurt, because I really hurt that year physically, and you know, made some decisions that now I've kind of put on the back burner a little bit after some in-depth conversations with my husband and my two kids. They've both encouraged me to, you know, Marcia, just take one day at a time, see what you can do, watch your health, and I'm still here, and I just take one day at a time. I don't know what tomorrow's gonna bring. I don't know what my plans are, but I just know that I'm here today, and that's what's most important.
She made the statement to me one time, if my kids don't want to run it, then I'll sell it. But I don't want to sell it as long as it can stay in the family. I can remember that.
I haven't really considered keeping Richwine's going myself as an owner, because I have a passion for my current business that I have, which is a daycare. As much as I love Burgerville, I'm not sure that I would be the person to run it.
If I ever wanted to take over Richwine's, I would love that. I know I could do it. I just don't have the funds or anything. Like, that would be really awesome to keep it in the family.
There have been a few people come in and work for us over the years that, oh yeah, they thought they would like to have it. But after they've worked a season, you don't hear about that anymore. People don't realize how hard the work is.
I've honestly thought about how, what if I took over? What if one of my friends and I took over? But I'm unsure as to where it will go, but I hope that it stays true to what it is in the sense of values and the tradition of it all, using the notepads, keeping the same food, keeping the same atmosphere, and hopefully stays within the family.
I have thought about taking over Burgerville, and I feel the pressure a little bit. You know, everybody says, oh, your plans are, you know, you just graduated high school. You know, what do you want to do? Oh, you're going to take over Burgerville, or, you know, you're going to be in Burgerville one day. And I always tell them no and laugh at them. But I think it might happen. I don't know. I don't know how it's gonna end. I don't want to, but I feel if I needed to, it would happen. I see myself having my own career and doing my own things, but if I ended up back here and it's what needed to be done, I think it could happen.
If Cassidy wanted to run it after college, I would support her, and I would ask if I could have a job.
They taught me a lot of good things in life. Probably some of the most important people in my life, if you want to know the truth. Because those were some really, really difficult times in life. And just that experience. So I'm very, very thankful for them, for that whole family, for that building, for the Burgerville. Confidence, real confidence. And I needed that, and I got it, and it helped.
Winter must be coming, because if Burgerville's closing, well, then we know it's gonna be a long season, so let's go down and get your fix.
Pretty much addicted to it now.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
And when Burgerville closes, you have to make it that last weekend before they run out of the meat. Because I don't know what they put in their hamburger meat, but it's like crack to our family. So we got to go get that last fix before they close.
I'll collect on Susie. That way she doesn't have to reach across her pickup. Hi, you guys! Oh, thank you, you two. Thanks, you guys. There you go. So she'll come visit with you. They're from Missoula, so they drove all the way to Missoula today just to eat. So that's pretty awesome. And I'm delivering this order to my first grade teacher. I wanted to hand deliver this to you.
No.
Yes. There you go.
You're special to me. I just wanted to say thank you.
This whole place, especially because of you, is special to me.
Wow. Have a good day.
You have a good.
I will. Thanks, hon.
She fun.
Yeah.
All right, Mr. Ty. Okay, if you want to take the one and put it over here, put it right here. And then we'll go grab the other and put it behind that guy, and then when he moves forward, so right there, there we go. Couple cars there. I've left the open sign on this side, Brandy. Richwine's Burgerville. Oh, hi, Gary, how are you? It's right now, we've got one lane closed. It's 3 o'clock, we're closing at 3. I've got one lane closed and we only have one lane open. So if you can get here in the next 5 minutes, you might be. Do you want to call in order? You tell me what you want. Yep. That's it? All righty. And you just come on up to the east side walk up window, okay? Thanks, Gary. We'll see you soon. Bye bye. I need one small fry, please.
Down to the last tray.
The last is off.
How are you? Good. The last one. There you go. Well, we're glad you stopped. You have a great winter, okay? Okay, Ty. Behind this white vehicle on the east, please.
Go fast. Run.
It means that the person in line gets the last best burger. So it's their lucky day.
I still have a few years before I can truly officially retire, so if I didn't work at Burgerville, I'd have to have something else that I would have to do. Would I like to see it, that I'm still there in 5 years? If these two support me to do that, then yes, but it's what my body will handle also. This is very, very hard work on the body. So I got to take one day at a time.
You're not gonna ever have your best day. It's a one day at a time because you never know if it's gonna be your last. And we live by that pretty harshly after Grandma passed away. You never know what you could be diagnosed with. You never know what you could, you know, you may not wake up after falling asleep on the couch like Grandpa did. You never know when your last day is gonna come. And so enjoying each other's company and having fun with it and laughing, that's what makes it all special. And that's what's important. So no matter if you drop something or something doesn't go your way, or it's not about that, it's about being together, and you're never gonna have your best day. But making most of what you have so far is good enough.
Take it home, and it has maintenance work that needs done, and then winterize it.
Thank you.
we've been enjoying this special presentation of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties. What a great family story. I'm John Twiggs, one of the program producers here at Montana PBS.
And I'm Anna Rao. I'm also a program producer here at Montana PBS. And thanks for watching with us tonight.
We know you appreciate shows like this. We want to hear from you tonight. We want you to become a sustaining member. And when you do, we've got some great thank you gifts to pass along.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month, or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
Those are some fun thank you gifts. You know, part of our mission here at Montana PBS is to tell Montana stories. And that doesn't happen without your financial support. It could be stories like the one you're enjoying tonight of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, or any number of documentaries or our regular series like Backroads of Montana or Montana Ag Live. But to keep that, we need your financial support. So become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. Not only do you get one of those great thank you gifts, but you also become a member of Montana PBS Passport, a great online service where you can have access to all of your favorite shows anytime on demand. Now's the perfect time to become a sustaining member. Make the call or go online and help support Montana PBS. And thank you.
And once again, we're lucky to have the producer and the director of this program, Mr. David King, here with us in the studio. Thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. And I always have that, you know, as a producer, you always have something left over that didn't make it in that you really wish you could have put in there. What kinds of things did you have as kind of bonus material that didn't make it in that you would have loved to have in there?
Well, the original film is feature length, so it's 22 minutes longer than what we're watching tonight. It includes Marcia and her daughter doing the annual flower planting out back and telling stories while they do it about the wheelbarrow that Aunt Peggy went and retrieved and that kind of thing. It also includes a lot more of Marcia's altruistic activity. She's very involved in charities. And we had to cut some of that out to meet the 1 hour time slot.
Yeah, and it sounds like you might have some of that those extras in the DVD, right?
Yes.
If people order that.
About 21 minutes of additional material, things that I really didn't want to take out, but I think it works well as we're watching it. But it's fun to be able to share with people who get the DVD a whole lot more.
So did you become personally invested in this? It seems like towards the end, you can tell you have a love for this business, kind of like a love letter to Burgerville. How do you feel about Marcia and her family?
They are family, just like everybody who goes there feels like family. Everyone, as mentioned in the film, you go there and they care about you. They know you. They know your order. They know what you're up to. Marcia is beloved by our kids. I mean, I have a one-year-old and a three-year-old, and they love Burgerville already.
I was struck by one of the lines that Cassidy had where she said, it's deep roots to something special. That seems like a very mature thing for a person her age to say. Do you see her as kind of the future of Burgerville when Marcia hangs up her apron, or do you have a sense of that?
That would be very controversial for me to weigh in on that.
Okay.
I think Cassidy is very talented. I think her insight at that moment, whenever I hear it, I think, oh my goodness, that should be the name of the film. We almost did it, deep roots to something special. I think she's very mature. She'll do what she wants to do, and Marcia and her husband Cameron will support her in that.
Great. Well, Mr. David King, the producer-director, thanks so much for joining us, and thanks for traveling down from Polson. We appreciate it. Yeah. And if you like this type of program, if this is something you feel a connection to, give us a call. Let us know you feel that way, and consider some special gifts we'll put in the mail for you.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
As you watched this show tonight, it became very clear how important this business, the small business, was and is to the Polson community. What do you think that importance is, John? I mean, do you see that as you drive around and talk to these small businesses? What is that mean?
I think you do. I mean, I think you see the value of it, and it's part of the character of each community because it makes it unique. I mean, a chain is a chain, really. I mean, that's, they're going to be the same, and they have to be the same everywhere you go. Whereas when you go to the different communities and you see small local businesses, and it really gives character to the community. And the other thing, of course, that comes out is just how incredibly difficult it is to make it work. I mean, the work that you see throughout the documentary, it really hits home in terms of what a battle it is in order to make that happen. But we're so thankful that they do, because like I said, that's what gives a character and flavor to the community, is those hardworking small businesses all across the state of Montana.
Yeah, it's worth it for the fabric of that community, and losing it would mean so a big hit to the community, definitely.
Yeah, it just wouldn't be the same, and you can hear people reminisce about that all the time. It wouldn't be the same without it, and that's why you're always thankful that you have hardworking folks in the community.
Right, and we believe Montana would not be the same without Montana PBS. If you believe that too, give us a call. Let us know you'll become a sustaining member. Thank you.
Show your support for great local programming on Montana PBS by making a sustaining pledge of $7 per month or a one-time pledge of $84, and we'll say thank you with a DVD of tonight's program, Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, produced by David W. King. With a donation of $108 or a sustaining pledge of $9 per month, you'll receive the functional Montana PBS lunch bag, as well as a 10-ounce insulated cup. With a sustaining pledge of $10 per month or a one-time pledge of $120, you'll choose between two combos. First, you'll get the book 56 Counties by author Russell Rowland, along with the program DVD. Or you can choose a map of Flathead Lake created by Montana's own Explorer Maps, along with the DVD. With your donation of $144 or a sustaining pledge of $12 per month, we'll thank you with the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, and the DVD of tonight's program. And for a sustaining pledge of $21 per month or a one-time pledge of $252, we'll send you tonight's entire package, including the 56 Counties book, the Flathead Lake map, the DVD of Burgers, Fries, and Family Ties, the Montana PBS lunch bag, and the 10-ounce cup. Thank you for your continued support of Montana programs on Montana PBS.
Oh, what a great evening it has been. It's been so much fun celebrating this documentary. And of course, we want lots of people to thank, not only the folks calling in, but we want to thank our guests tonight, Marcia and David. They did a great job and gave us great insight into the production. And it's just been great fun.
Yeah, it was really a privilege to sit down and talk to them and get a little extra kind of behind the scenes and hear about what Marcia does in the off season. It was just a wonderful night. Thanks for being part of it.
Yes, and we appreciate hearing from you. You still have time. You can still go to the phone, make that call, or go online and pledge your support. Become a sustaining member of Montana PBS. This is what makes it work. This is what makes productions like this possible. Other local productions, again, it's part of our mission to tell Montana stories on Montana PBS, and we very much want to hear from you. So from all of us here, thank you once again, and thank you for supporting Montana PBS.
Have a good night.
Programming on Montana PBS is made possible in part by viewers like you, the friends of Montana PBS. Thank you. And by Davis Brothers Auction, a Montana-based modern-age auction house with the knowledge and technology to help you purchase, consign,
passing of neighborliness.
Tuesday evening at 7.
C is for
communities, which help kids grow smarter, stronger, and kinder. And we have resources for the challenges and joys families experience. It's all on Sesame Street in communities.org, where you'll find activities and videos for kids and grown-ups.
C is for community and cookie. Om nom nom nom.
Join us at Sesame Street in communities.org.
I wouldn't be the same person today without 4-H. It has created such an impact on my life. Each time I worked on a 4-H project, I became a better person. I changed. I was able to help others and learn from others. It was something that I'll never forget, and it's something that has shaped my life in a way that nothing else has.
Monday, March 8th.
She left a life of privilege in England and found a sense of peace on the Montana prairie. Evelyn Cameron's photographs and diaries provide an experience for all generations.
Thursday evening at 7.
Love, look at the two of us.
The Carpenters return. Close to you, remembering the Carpenters.
Tuesday, March 9th.
Can you all live the ultimate retirement? You can.
Acclaimed personal finance expert Susie Orman provides essential advice to make your retirement more successful and secure.
It's never too soon to begin.
Tuesday, March 9th. Saturday evening at 8. This program was made possible in part by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Tonight.
Woo! Hello, everybody.
Performing from the home of country music, a living legend.
In the wink of an eye.
Celebrates a musical milestone. Join Dolly Parton and her star guests as she marks 50 years as a member of the Grand Ole Opry. Spectacular songs, incredible music, and the one and only Dolly Parton. Ladies and gentlemen, celebrating 50 years as a member of the Grand Ole Opry, please welcome Dolly Parton.
Let's do 9-5. Let's everybody get in on this one.
Kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition, yawn and stretch and try to come to life. I jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping, out on the streets the traffic starts jumping, with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5, yeah! Working